Novak Djokovic missed out on the first Grand Slam of 2022 after being deported from Australia, and is placed at future major tournaments is by no means guaranteed due to his vaccination status. A leading tennis pundit has reminded fans that Novak Djokovic's future remains uncertain after he was denied a chance to play in the first Grand Slam of the year. The Serbian missed out on the Australian Open after being deported, and the competition was eventually won by rival Rafael Nadal. The Djokovic saga dominated the headlines in the build-up to the tournament, after he was held by officials upon his arrival at Melbourne Airport. He had traveled down under after declaring on social media that he had been granted a medical exemption from the travel rule which requires all arriving travelers to be double vaxxed. His visa was cancelled by the Border Force, and it later emerged that his application form had been filled in incorrectly. It also became public that the unvaccinated tennis star had appeared for an interview with French media and met with a children in the days after he had tested positive for COVID-19. Djokovic's lawyer saved him from immediate deportation by appealing, beginning a lengthy process which caused furore for more than a week. Eventually, after two court hearings and plenty of bad blood on both sides, the government's deportation order was upheld and the world number one was on a plane back to Serbia. With Djokovic not there and Roger Federer also absent through injury, it gave Nadal the chance to pull ahead of August in terms of Grand Slam titles. It was an opportunity the Spaniard duly took, coming back to beat Daniil Medvedev in a memorable Melbourne final. Now that the dust has settled, tennis pundit Andrew Kessel has spoken about the situation and warned that Djokovic's troubles may yet be far from over. The only camera we were missing down in Australia was one on Novak's face on match point when Nadal made it to número 21, he told Tennis 365. After seeing that, I can imagine Novak's motivation will be 100% moving forward. We don't know whether he can play at the French Open because of what French President Emmanuel Macron has said about everyone needing to be vaccinated, but he's going to be incredibly motivated wherever he plays. While we rightly celebrated that magnificent final with Nadal and Medvedev, Djokovic has won that tournament 9 times and we just want to see him there. I want to see the very best giving it one last slog over the next year, 2 years or 3 years. So I miss Novak down there, regardless of my personal opinion of the way he conducted himself. Kessel had been referring to the news that all athletes arriving in France will need to be vaccinated unless they have a genuine medical reason as to why they have not had the jab. Having returned a positive test in mid-December, it's possible Djokovic might be able to get an exemption for the French Open in May on the basis that he would have had a positive test in the previous 6 months. I'm a journalist and tennis is my love, but as a news story this Djokovic saga had so much and I found it fascinating, Kessel later continued. My own personal view is he wasn't treated entirely correctly at all times in that one. There was a vast amount of politics in it, with the elections in Australia and the restrictions they had to endure were so difficult. With a bit of luck it fizzles out and he can get back to doing what he does best. Djokovic is due to play his first tournament of 2021 in Dubai later this month. As well as at the French Open, the Serbian might face difficulties in his bid to play at Wimbledon and the US Open later this year depending on what the rules around vaccination are at the time.